doesn't look like militia. You don't look very militia to me.
Nah, man. Name's Wade. Wade Taylor. You can call me Wade.
Deacon St. John.
Holy shit. Deacon St. John. Is your old man a preacher or something?
No.
Man, that is a hell of a name.
All right, listen.
You Wade. See this, man? This is some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Whew. So what? You joining up? Becoming an army man? Playing soldier and shit?
I don't know. Maybe. Listen, you look like you just came in from out the shit, right?
Yeah, man, yesterday.
Okay,
yesterday. I've been waiting to see the colonel, whatever the hell that is.
Traveling with some people, we got separated. You see anyone that looked like this around here?
Nah, man. Ooh, she is a looker. I'd hit that, you know. I gotta go, man. They're checking me for lice or some shit. Good luck to you, Deacon St. John. Jesus, what a name.
Jesus, that dude's fucked up. He wouldn't remember Sarah if she slapped him in the face. Come on, Sarah, come on. Where the hell are you? You're here. Somewhere. Maybe in these tents.
Why are you not working hard? Why are you still in my obstacle course? Why are you not...
Maybe in here. The infirmary. I mean, with her background, that's where she would be, right? No, not here. Check this one. Ah, damn it. She's not here either. It's gotta be the one. Sarah? Sarah, you in here? Shit, not here. God damn it, she's not here. She's not here, but... Right, yeah, it couldn't be that easy. I could.
St. John, you on this channel? Corporal Russell said you had a radio.
Yeah, I'm here.
Meet me at the gate.
On my way.
What's up?
Hey.
New around here? Name's Ava Bergstrom. Friends call me Bergie.
Deacon St. John. Yeah, I just got here.
Well, Deacon St. John, you do your job, and we'll get along just fine. How's that?
Yes, ma'am.
You need something? That all you need? Okay.
Let's work, people. Keep moving.
Hey. Yes,
hey.
I haven't seen you around before. Lucas Monroe.
Yeah, I just shipped in, you know. Deacon St. John.
Well, take a look around. I got all kinds of bike parts, if you got credits.
Yeah, thanks.
All right, then. Need a fill-up there? Well, there you go. Oh, okay, then. Stop by soon. Hey there.
Hello.
I'm getting ready to ride out. You still coming?
Ready when you are.
So you put a lot of work into this.
Yeah, some.
Open it up!
Are you any good? Can you ride?
Yeah. Yeah, I can ride.
Join the militia? You're gonna have to
looks like a forest fire, but the stumps are charred. That means that the timber was cut before it was burned.
You got a good eye. We call it the dead zone. We use the timber to build our barricades, then burn the slash. From the outpost, we can see a fort coming long before it reaches us.
What? You're gonna burn all the buildings, too, so the newts and swarmers have nowhere to sleep?
You know your freaks, huh?
Like I said, I've been out in the ship for a long time. So that's your plan, huh? The militia, I mean, to burn everything to the ground?
We're fighting a war out here, St. John. You do whatever it takes to win.
A war?
That's what it is, isn't it? War? You've been out in the shit. You've seen the hordes. The only thing that's gonna stop them is an army. Our army.
It's gonna take way more than an army.
We have a plan. The colonel lets you join.
There were some folks that I rode with once, and I thought maybe they ended up there.
I thought maybe you were after someone. For a bounty, I mean.
Yeah, no. I tracked men over long distances before, but not this far. No bounty's worth that.
Corporal, the captain's here.
It's done, sir.
Make sure you make a marker.
Yes, sir.
All right. You two head back to Diamond Lake. Grab, Taylor was his name?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Take him to the colonel. I'll be there in 1800.
Sir?
Military time, Corporal. You're supposed to know this by now.
Oh, yes, sir.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yes, sir.
You find something?
How long is,
Vasquez.
What has Vasquez been with you guys?
A couple of weeks, maybe more.
Well, he's been busy.
What the hell?
You guys been having trouble with supply runs, marauder attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go on foot from here.
On foot? Why?
Because Vasquez came out here for a reason. I can't track him from the bike.
Where do we start?
It's been snowing, so there won't be any boot prints. Come on, I want to look inside the cabin.
Okay, I'm following you.
I got a use for you. This. Yeah, I can always use this.
You, you said you stole rations, ammo?
Yes.
This is an MRE. It's half eaten, so looks like your men rode up on him when he wasn't expecting it. His bike's still out front. Which means that he went out the back. Wait, over here.
What'd you find?
The fence has been cut. And no rust.
So it was cut recently?
Yeah. Come on, this way.
Hey, hold on for a second.
Look.
Over here.
Tracks?
Yeah, we're in luck. This way.
Wait, hold up. You find something?
Yeah, shell casing. Recently fired. He stopped to shoot at something. Come on, down here.
Go on. Get out of here.
What are you doing? That ever work for you? Yelling at a wolf?
Depends.
On what?
On how hungry it is.
Look out! More wolves!
I see him. That's the last of them.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks like it. Nice work.
Neat. I want to take a look at this thing. Looks like the MREs weren't enough for your man. Clean gunshot, right through the head.
Yeah, the wolves must have heard the shot. Decided they wanted it more than Vasquez.
Yeah, the rest of the pack came at us from back that way, from the east.
You think they chased off Vasquez, leaving one to guard the carcass?
That's my guess.
Come on, let's see if you're right.
You guys got a lot of wolves out here? Ones that aren't infected, I mean?
Yeah, we get reports almost every day.
When I was a kid growing up, there were no wolves in Oregon. I mean, a few coyotes, but no wolves. They've been driven to extinction by ranchers and farmers, timber companies.
Well, it looks like they're making a big comeback.
Hold up.
What is it?
It's a backpack.
It's one of ours.
Looks like they almost got to him.
And he shrugged off the pack to get away.
No. To buy time. He landed on his ass. Tried to scramble away, but then the wolf lunged. Vasquez dropped him. Two shots.
You can tell all that.
Yeah.
Hero gravesite. This one's marked on our map. They're scattered all over the region.
Maybe that explains why Vasquez came through here. Let's go around.
Exactly what I was thinking. St. John, this way.
Yeah, right there with you. I gotta say, I'm getting tired running and hiding from these sons of bitches.
You ever take on a swarm?
Yeah, I've done it before. You just gotta keep moving.
Well, look, if you're gonna join the militia, you must stay focused on the mission. We're not out here to fight freaks.
Being in the shit, killing freaks, kind of goes hand in hand, doesn't it? Okay, put some distance between us and the graves. The cold weather's gonna bring out even more of them. I think they can smell a corpse from about a mile out.
Part of our slash-and-burn strategy is to find these grave sites, dig them up, and burn them along with everything else.
Yeah, well, good luck with that. I've seen hundreds of them. It's just in this part of the state alone.
And we've got to start somewhere. All right, where now?
Keep heading east. Hey, there's a road ahead. Hold up a second.
What do you think?
Is anyone else tracking him?
Not that I know of.
Huh. Well, then he's either dead, or he's got a lot of friends. You see how his tracks have been overridden by bikes. A lot of bikes.
Okay. Come on. Let's see where they're heading.
You said cold weather brings out the freaks?
Yeah. Cold, snow, rain, hell, even clouds.
Well, like I said before, you know your freaks. When we get to command, there's some people who want to talk to you.
People?
The colonel will fill you in, if he lets you join.
Yeah, I think you said that already.
Look, he runs a tight outfit. I just don't want you to get your hopes up.
Hey, don't worry about me. I don't really give a damn either way. Hey, wait. Hear that?
Yeah, it's coming from the logging camp over there.
Is that on your map?
Yeah.
Wow, that means it's also on Vasquez's map.
Come on. If Vasquez is there, what would your strategy be?
Well, he's not alone. We know that from the tracks. What's that militia penalty for going AWOL?
Hanging by the neck until dead. Why?
Well, it means Vasquez isn't coming without a fight. See your man?
Yeah. That's him.
Well, looks like you guys need to start doing background checks on your recruits. He seems to be right at home.
Well, let's wait here. I'll radio for backup.
Get your goddamn hands off me!
Oh, this one's a fighter, boys! What do you think?
Oh, see about that.
Oh, hell no.
What?
I just got this problem with assholes who hurt unarmed women.
I'm giving you an order.
Order? You see me wearing a red armband? You don't give me orders yet. You do whatever the hell you want.
Thank you.
Got him. Easy, easy. I'm just here to help.
I don't need your goddamn help.
Okay. I'm just gonna move over here.
Stay the hell away from me!
Hold on now. We're not with them.
You think I give a damn who you are?
Okay.
How was that?
Just your typical damsel in distress.
Vasquez?
Done. Way done.
Captain Corey? Come in.
This is Corey.
We're here. Heading up the road to the main gate.
Hold your position there. We're coming.
What about the enemy?
They've been, neutralized. Hold your position. Curry out. Come on.
We brought up your bikes, Captain. Thought we'd save you the walk back.
That'll be all, Corporal.
So how'd I do? Did I pass?
Pass?
Oh, you've been watching me all day. I figured this was what? Some kind of test.
No. Nothing quite as formal as all that. As you can see, our pool of recruits isn't what it used to be.
Yeah.
But yeah, you passed.
Third day in a row.
So, you ready to meet the colonel?
Yeah, sure. Why the hell not?
So, St. John, where did you serve? Before the ship went down. And you know what an MRE looks like. You know how to recon an enemy position. You know cover in advance, tactical maneuvers. So, where did you serve? Marines? Army?
I try not to talk about it, you know? First year out here, it seemed like anyone who used to wear a uniform had a target on their back. I was in the Army. 10th Mountain. I did a full tour in Afghanistan. So how about you? Anyone who's ex-military has a certain bearing. None of your soldiers have it, but you do.
Like I said, you got a good eye. I was in the Air Force 10 years. Part of SAC.
There ain't no missile silos in Oregon.
I was on vacation, believe it or not. I was lucky. Before SATCOM went down, I got hourly reports from across the country. You think it was bad out here? Everything east of the Mississippi was overrun within 2 days.
So, are you familiar with this area?
Yeah, I grew up in a town north from here. It's called Farewell, you know it?
No. It sounds like a fitting place to be living at the end of the world.
Yeah, tell me about it.
So maybe you have been here before.
Yeah, I've been here. A few summers back, me and my old lady, or my wife, stopped by here on her honeymoon.
You got a pic? Of your wife, I mean. Her name was Carrie. We were married 12 years when... Anyway, it was a long time ago.
You know, I think this might mean keep out.
Huh? Oh, no, that doesn't apply to us.
Why, because we can't read?
Because we don't obey the law.
Speak for yourself.
After you.
All right. You know, making me a co-conspirator, not very chivalrous.
Chival what?
It means, right. I never learn. I'm sorry about that.
Oh my God, you should have seen the look on your face.
Oh, I bet it was funny.
Yeah, if I'd owned a cell phone, I'd have taken a picture.
Well, for just this once, I'm glad that you don't.
Oh, come on, don't start on that again.
Hey, I didn't say anything. You brought it up.
You just did.
So, where are we going?
Just follow the trail. You'll see that it's not that far.
What would my mom say if she knew I was out on a midnight stroll in the middle of nowhere with an outlaw biker?
Well, I don't know. She'd say, honey, you better wear your sweater.
Very funny.
Yeah, she wouldn't say anything, you know? You weren't supposed to tell them about us, remember?
Oh, come on, Deacon, I said that a long time ago. You know I didn't mean that.
Hey, look, I'm not judging. I haven't told my old man.
That's because your father's dead.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's that.
The question is, have you told anyone in the MC that you're dating a nice girl from Seattle and not some bimbo from whatever strip club you guys live in?
Oh, well, okay, wait a second. No, we don't live in a strip club. I mean, we have a lifetime membership there. That's true, but we don't live there. And second, I did tell them. Yeah, matter of fact, I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah. Oh, come on, don't sound so surprised. They find your PhDs to be very sexy.
Oh, yeah, I bet. So, you know this is way past my bedtime, right?
Oh, I know.
Oh, come on, stop. I mean, I really do have to get up early tomorrow.
Yeah? How's that going? I mean, you never want to talk about it, so...
It's nothing. It's just... project. I mean, we've got these execs flying in from New York to audit our progress, and the suits at our facility are installing a new lab without even showing me the spec, and...
Ooh, well, I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
Sorry, it's just... You know, like I said, it's nothing. Anyway, thank you for dragging me away from all that.
Yeah, no problem.
Wait, is this a pop card? Is this what you wanted to show me?
Say what?
Well, these are marijuana plants, and that's an irrigation system, so this here, this is a pot farm.
Oh, hey, yeah, look at that, pot farm.
You dragged me out in the middle of the night to the middle of nowhere to show me the MC's illegal growing operation.
Yeah?
Actually, what you wanted to show me, right?
No, of course it's not. Come on, keep following the trail, we're almost there.
You think I would learn? You think I would learn, but I never learn.
Nope.
Oh my God. God, look at that moonlight. It's so beautiful.
Keep going. We're almost there.
You ever wonder what it would be like if just everywhere all at once the lights went out and everyone could just see the world just like this?
What, you mean, like all dark and shadowy and depressing?
I mean the moonlight, the wildflowers, the fireflies. I see you were kidding again. Okay, you don't take anything seriously.
Oh, I take everything seriously.
Oh, yeah, right.
I do.
You do not. Like when I suggested moving some of my stuff over to your place, you pretended that I was joking.
No, that's not true. I pretended I didn't hear you. There's a big difference.
You should have seen the look on your face. And you know, I do have a cell phone and I took a picture. You want me to show you?
My God, you're a scientist. Can we be rational about this?
Okay. First of all I said is that we should think about moving in together. You know, because we'd get to spend more time together and, you know, take the next step. What's irrational about that?
I have a toothbrush at your place.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? You're right. That is a huge commitment.
Well, I mean, do you know how much a good toothbrush costs?
Okay, see, there you go again. Every time I try to talk about our future, you turn it into a joke.
Okay, all right. We do need to talk about it, and we will talk about it, but just hold on for a second, because I want to show you something, okay? See? This is why I brought you out here.
Wow, how beautiful.
Was it worth it?
God, yes.
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Yeah? Deacon?
Will you...
Will I?
Will you, So that a yes?
On two conditions.
Name them.
Okay, well, the first one is that we don't have one of those biker weddings where you say that you're going to ride me as much as your bike.
Done. I couldn't promise that anyway.
Oh, stop. Okay, the second one is that you never leave me.
Done.
God, did you just break your biker ring on my finger?
You know what? I think I probably did.
Look at it. It's so cute with its little fangs just like clenching onto the chain. You know, nothing says true love like
dog skulls.
Dog skull. Hey, what does it say there?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you knew Latin.
Come on.
It's Morier Invictus. It means death before defeat.
Wow, I like that. Well, you're going to get me. Real ring, though, right? No, that this one's not
absolutely
great.
Because
I just
thought that's my ring,
right? It's your ring. Right. Something more simple without fangs.
Okay,
all right. Shit, I'm sorry.
No, it's your ring.
It's the lab, I gotta get it.
Okay,
hello, yeah, no, that's fine. I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. They need me back there. What? I gotta go.
This minute? Like, this time of night?
I'm sorry. I have to go, but I promise I'll make it up to you.
Okay.
Come on.
My wife's name was, Beth. No, I don't have a pick.
Let's go.
Unusual, you know.
I'm sorry, what's that?
To not have any photos of your wife, family.
Yeah, why do you say that?
Back in the day, everyone used smartphones. That's where we kept all our photos. The phones went away, the cloud went away, our photos went with them.
Yeah, I guess I hadn't thought about that.
My wife, Carrie. Her father was a photographer. Old school. Dark room, chemicals, all that. Too stubborn to embrace the digital age, I think. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have any photos either.
Yeah, well, I hated them. Cell phones, I mean. Seemed like everyone walked around with their noses buried in the damn things. I never owned one.
Interesting. How'd you manage that?
I worked as a mechanic. I had my own shop. Probably had the last landline in Farewell.
How's it going, soldier?